हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग प्रोग्राम मैडम आनंदी। हेलो, डॉक्टर नागभूषण, आर यू देयर ऑनलाइन?
गुड मॉर्निंग सर, गुड मॉर्निंग सिरिल सर, गुड मॉर्निंग पार्टिसिपेंट्स। सिरिल सर, कैन वी जस्ट वेट फॉर टू मोर मिनट्स एंड जस्ट वेट फॉर सम ऑफ पार्टिसिपेंट्स टू जॉइन बिफोर वी स्टार्ट।
We'll do it, but I need your help.
Yes, sir. Please tell me, sir.
See, I'm trying to share my screen, but how do I share the entire screen? Is it possible?
I will stop sharing, sir.
No, not now. Suppose you want to share the entire screen, because when I run my MATLAB program,
yes, sir,
it opens up multiple different images.
Okay.
So every time I have to keep exiting the screen share again, stop sharing the tabs.
Okay.
Is there a possibility where I can share the whole screen?
I'll find out and tell you in 1 minute.
Okay.
I'll ask the team. So the team is just checking on that because already it's around 9:35. We can start as soon as we get that information. I'll share it with you, sir.
We can start.
Okay, sir. I will stop share and then already we have introduced Professor Cyril Raj. So I will hand it over to sir. Look forward to the continuation, sir, of the topics. Thank you, sir.
Okay. So very good morning to all participants and the organizers. Again, thanks for giving me this opportunity to share my views on VLSI architectures for neural network design. So I'll share my screen. I think the screen is visible to all of you. Raghuram, screen is visible, right?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So let's quickly get into the process. So today, in continuation with the session that we had last on Tuesday, that is on VLSI architectures for neural network. So we will continue with that and we'll see how to design some very specific architectures which could be extended for even designing a CNN architecture or any kind of deep learning architectures. Now, before I could start, my sincere apologies to participants, those interested to learn software approaches for ANN or DNN or DL design. Because here in this session, I'll be mostly focusing on hardware implementation of ANN as a set, which could be extended to implement CNN structures on a ASIC platform or on a FPGA platform. So the session overview is as follows. So first we will estimate what would be the complexity in implementing an ANN on a hardware. Considering the example that we kind of took last session. Then we'll see what are the design methods that are available to reduce the computation complexity. We will try to take at least some 2-3 methods and see how design thinking can be brought into design of ANN so that it can reduce the computation complexity. Lastly, we'll also see how to implement the design on FPGA and validate the design. So the session objective is to estimate computation complexity for ANN implementation and design novel methods. I'm calling it as novel methods because most of them we have patented. And some of them are already there in the literature, but used for different other techniques and optimizing design complexities. So at the end of this session, I hope all the participants will be able to learn how hardware design can be brought into picture to reduce design complexities for ANN implementation on a VLSI platform. I'll be using MATLAB and Xilinx for this process. A quick recap with regarding to the last session. This is the MATLAB program that we were able to work out, and this MATLAB program is particularly for compressing an image, and I have taken Apple Orange and I have trained the neural network to compress the image. Then when I run this code, we also know that yes, it is able to perform the compression activity. So I just run the code, and when I run the code, it generates a lot of multiple designs, multiple windows. I'll pop it up and show it across you one by one. So if you see the figure one, this is the input image that we have considered for training the network. Then with that image, we were able to convert that image from color to RGB, grayscale, RGB to grayscale. That is what we are able to see there. So colors have been totally changed. Okay, then we resized that image. So the resizing was done and we were able to get a resized image. So this is the resized image. So if you try to resize the image, obviously the sharpness in the image is vanished. And you find that this image is 32 cross 32. After resizing this image, we converted that image from 2D to 1D. So this is the first image is the apple, second image again apple, third image is the orange and the orange. We converted it from 2D to 1D. Then after converting it from 2D to 1D, then we further combined all the images together. This is the combined image, which is now forming the data set for training the network. Yeah. Once the network is trained, this is the output that I generate, which is actually from the network, and given an orange as an input. So it is able to generate orange as an output. This is the output what we generate. So now, keeping this as an example, let us see how to go back and design our network. Okay. Yeah. Yes. So the design that we have taken today for the structure that we have taken today for optimization is this, wherein we have the compressor and the decompressor. Okay. So we have the compressor and the